Here in Georgia, peanuts generate over $800 million to the state's economy. Therefore, it is vital that the crop is healthy and producers stay profitable.
Yeah, one of the biggest threats to the crop is a disease called tomato spotted wilt virus, which can literally wipe out a crop. Mark Wildman has a story on how important work is now being conducted at UGA to combat this disease.
Out in the peanut fields of Georgia, producers like to see healthy crops. Over the years, peanut yields have risen greatly, and the farmers are able to harvest the best peanuts in the world. But some of the most important work being done with peanuts takes place in buildings like this one at UGA's Tifton campus. Here at the entomology department, Babu Srinivasan is researching tomato spotted wilt virus, which can devastate a peanut crop.
Tomato spotted wilt virus has been a big problem for Georgia's agriculture. It's just tens of millions of dollars that we've lost over the last 15, 20 years.
His research centers around thrips.
These are minute insects, I would say 1 to 2 millimeters long. So they actually are present everywhere. There are over 7,000 species of thrips. It's just that we don't pay attention to them. But what we are concerned about is only a handful of those, especially in the southeastern U.S. We are concerned only about 2 or 3 different species, and we are concerned mainly about them not because of the feeding damage that they cause on plants, but also the viruses they transmit.
Farmers follow a variety of different strategies to control their risk for the virus, which include planting certain varieties and making sure they plant at the right time. But the study here is using a technique called transcript optics.
And what we basically do in this process is come up with a number of genes that are available in an insect at a given point of time, and we actually then screen these genes or identify these genes to see if we can use them for pest management, exploit them for pest management for at a later on time period. Granted that the research that we do now is actually it's just starting. It may take many number of years before we can actually exploit this for pest management, but it's something that we can actually use later on. It has been used in other systems, and by doing this, we can reduce the amount of pesticides that are used in the field, and we can also use other pest management tactics.
The work being done here is being done with funds from the peanut industry. Every year, the peanut farmers give back a certain percentage of the money they earn off their crops to fund important research projects.
Most of our funding comes from the National Peanut Board, as well as the Georgia Peanut Commission. And some of our funds also come from the USDA. So all these are very important partners for us as far as doing research is concerned. It's most of their money that actually goes into funding our research.
This project is just one of the many ways science is helping farmers grow healthy crops while reducing the amount of chemicals needed to control pests. In Tifton, I'm Mark Wildman for the Georgia Farm Monitor.